गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर ऑन द फेस ऑफ इट पार्ट थर्ड। सो वी आर रीडिंग अबाउट द कन्वर्सेशन बिटवीन मिस्टर लैम एंड डेरी। सो मिस्टर लैम इज सिटिंग इन हिज गार्डन एंड मास्टर डेरी मीन्स द लिटिल बॉय दैट इज 14 ईयर्स ओल्ड sneakily or stealthily has entered in the garden, and there he was noticed by Mr. Lamb, and after being noticed he was very much surprised, he was very much shocked, and he was not happy to be in the company of Mr. Lamb, and he wanted to leave the place as soon as possible. So see the conversation, and we'll come to know with the help of their conversation that who is what type of people. Like Mr. Lamb is very much optimistic, Derry is very much pessimistic, having very negative thoughts. Mr. Lamb is having very positive thought. So we have the clue of all these information in this story. Mr. Lamb, know not the whole of you, not of you. Mr. Lamb is telling that, know not the whole of you, not of you. Means he is just telling that you are good, but I am not. Means you are looking at me and criticizing my appearance and ugly look in my mind. Derry, yes, a little pause is there, and then Mr. Lamb is telling here, later on when it is a bit cooler, I will get the ladder and a stick and pull down those crab apples. Means this was his planning of Mr. Lamb, that he wanted to pluck some of the crab apples, with the help of ladder and a stick. He will climb on the ladder and will help the take the stick and will just try to pluck the apples, and then he will use the apples in making jam and jelly. They are ripe for it, means they are now perfect for jelly. And completely ripe. I make jelly. It is a good time of year, September. Look at them, orange and golden. That is magic fruit. I often say, but it is best picked and made into jelly. You could give me a hand. And now Mr. Lamb wanted to involve Derry in his work. In this way, he can just forget his, ugly look or burnt face, and expecting help from Derry's side. Means he proposed him that you please help me, or you can help me while plucking and plucking the crab apples and just collecting them, and then just making jelly and jam of the apples. Derry, what have you changed the subject for? People always do that. Why don't you ask me? Miss Derry is just replying of these questions when he was asked to give his hand, help him in the process of plucking the crab apples. So now he's replying and responding that what have you changed this subject for? Means why you are changing the subject? Why you are not speaking straight? People always do that. Means he is trying to say that people always keep this feeling in their mind, and they just think about my appearance and ugly look, and generally this happens before me. Why don't you ask me? Why do you do what they all do and pretend it isn't true? and isn't true. He is telling that the things you are thinking, that you are having in your mind, that you are thinking, you are thinking that I am an ugly, and and this makes you upset. Don't you think like this? Means he is trying to say that because of my ugly appearance, you are upset, unhappy, and that upsetting nature, that unhappy nature, you are not going to disclose before me, but you are actually unhappy. These things he wanted to say, and he is telling that you are pretending that you love my company, okay, you love my presence here in the garden, all do and pretend it isn't true and isn't there. In case I see you looking and mind and get upset, he is telling that you never liked my presence here, okay, you look at me and become upset. I will tell you, don't ask me because you are afraid to. He is telling that you are even afraid of me, Mr. Lamb. You want me to ask, say so. Then I don't like being with people and any people. Now Derry is telling that he does not like the company of anyone and he does not want to be with people. Mr. Lamb, I should say, to look at it, I should say you got burned in a fire. Now Mr. Lamb is taking interest and wanted to know that how Derry's face was burned. Now see, Derry is giving explanation. Not in a fire, I got acid all down that side of my face and it burned it all away. And now Derry is just giving explanation that how it was burned. How it was burned? This may be one short question, that how Derry's face was burned. So he will just give explanation of this question, that it was burned due to the falling of acid. It ate my face up. It ate me up. The eating refers to just completely destroyed, decayed, okay, due to the acid. And now it is like this and it won't ever be any different. And now he is telling that it will not regain its natural color. Means once again, it will not look like as I was initially. So it has just completely burned. Mr. Lamb, no. Derry, aren't you interested? Mr. Lamb, you are a boy who came into the garden plenty do. Means he is telling that you are a small boy and many other children also visit in this garden. I am interested in anybody, anything. So this is the very positive nature of Mr. Lamb. There is nothing God made that doesn't interest me. See the high, very high positive thinking. He is telling that I love everything God made. Look over there, over beside the far wall. What can you see? Now he is testing, okay, the psychology, the mindset, and the positive and negative aspects of Mr. Derry, Master Derry, telling him to look towards the wall, and what can you see? See the reply of Derry. Derry, rubbish. There's nothing I could see. Okay, these are only plants and nothing. Means according to him, it is very rubbish questions, worthless. Mr. Lamb, rubbish. Look, boy, look. What do you see? Just grass and stuff, weeds. Now this time he gave the exact answer. He told that he could see grass and stuff and weeds. So here weeds यू आर फैमिलियर विथ इन इन एलिमेंट्री स्कूल क्लासरूम इन असलम वीड्स अनवांटेड प्लांट नो वीड्स आर एक्चुअली अनवांटेड प्लांट दैट जनरली ग्रोज अप इन द वीट फील्ड सो हियर ही इज टेलिंग दैट ग्रास एंड स्टफ वीड्स मिस्टर लैम सम कॉल देम वीड्स इफ यू लाइक देन अ वीड गार्डन दैट That is the very, high positive nature. There is fruit and there are flowers. Means the wheat plants also contain flower and fruit in it. And trees and herbs also. Means this is the importance of the wheat plant. All sorts. But over there, weeds. I grow weeds there. Why is one grain growing plant called a weed? And another flower. Where is the difference? It is all life, growing same as you and me. Now this is the very important point about the character of, about the positivity of, about the goodness of, about the optimism of Mr. Lamb. Indirectly, the narrator has highlighted here. That all things are important. Later he will just explain the concept of relativity that I will just give you explanation. The narrator is telling through the character of Mr. Lamb that all the things in this world are made by the God himself and they bear equal importance if not more then not less to anything. He is telling that why a green plant is called a flower and the another a weed. Because they all have the same flower, same fruits and same greenery. So why we should hate the weed plant and why we should love the some other plant? This is the question the narrator wanted to know. Wanted to just explain that all the people have equal importance. So indirectly is telling that means we all human beings are equal and created and made by God himself. Internal structure is same, that is just like green. Like we have same bone, same flesh, same color of blood. So due to only a skin, why we will differentiate each other? Why we will hate each other? It is the skin color that makes someone look good. Okay, or ugly, but from inside we should just polish ourselves, okay, refine ourselves and to be a good human. That means what? That means the character, that means the features. If you are good from inwards, okay, you are very nice, and if you are not, then you are ugly, according to him. So this is the explanation he is giving, and this explanation is showing the height of optimism. Positivity. So that part is very much important. Okay. If the question is coming, sketch the character of Mr. Lamb. Give a brief characteristics of Mr. Lamb. So you will just give explanation of this. Means he was having very high positivity about his life, about nature, about everything around him. Okay. Or in this world. Diri. Now he's telling that it means you are going to say that we are not the same. Mr. Lamb, I am old, you are young. You have got a bald face and I have got a thin leg. Not important. Now he's telling that we have actually no difference at all in our appearance or about anything. He is telling that I am old, you are young. You have got a burnt face and I have got a thin leg. Not important, okay. Being burnt face, there is no excuse, okay, no complaint with that. Having thin leg, no complaint of this and that. You are standing there, I am sitting here, Where is the difference? Means the narrator wanted to say that we bear no difference at all. It is the matter of only a look. It is the matter of only a thought and the way we look at each other. We are same. We are similar, having no differences at all. Now see the reply of Derry. Derry, why have you got a thin leg? Now he's taking interest. Now he's developing interest in the character of Mr. Lamb and wanted to know that why Mr. Lamb got thin leg. So this may be one questions also, okay, short questions. A real one got blown off. Now this is the explanation. He's telling that the real one, the real leg of Mr. Lamb was blown off years back. So Lemmy Lamb, some kids say, means he was called by this name Lemmy Lamb. The children of the neighbors of Mr. Lamb, they just tease him, okay, while calling Lemmy Lamb. Kids say, haven't you heard them? Now he's asking, have you heard them that they call me Lemmy Lamb? You will Lemmy Lamb, or you can also say Lemmy Lamb, or you might be saying Lemmy Lamb. It fits, means I am Lamb. So he was Mr. Lamb and he was having Lemmy Lamb being called by the children. So he is telling that Lemmy Lamb, it fits, doesn't trouble me. That is the second optimism, okay, and the high level of positivity. He is telling that it fits, means I don't disagree with this comment. It's nice. It's okay because I look like that. I am like that. So doesn't trouble me, means I don't get upset. I don't get annoyed. I don't get unhappy when I am called or in when I was called, okay, Lemmy Lamb. So this is the height of adjustment, height of compromise, and height of, you know, understanding. Here we will have to just take this lesson from the character of Mr. Lamb, that if someone is criticizing you, if someone is commenting you, if someone is teasing you, you just shift your tune or attention from that man, okay, to something positive. Now we have, okay, we have great celebs and sportsmen, actors and actress. So they are many times criticized by the audience, but they don't take the comments otherwise because they know that these comments are good for them, and then they start working very hard and be a successful one. Here the lesson that we will have to take from this statement, that whatever people observation is about you, about us, we should not take it in otherwise. We should not take it in other way. We should take it very likewise, because if we will take it in other way or otherwise, it will only just harm us, okay, infuriate us, upset us, annoy us, and the man's intentions will be fulfilled. If someone is calling your name and because of that you are very much infuriated, angry, upset, so the man's intention will be, you know, successful. So he is telling that those who are criticizing you, those who are trying to trouble you, those who are trying to tease you, don't get upset because of their remark. Take it easy, okay, and be comfortable. One day they will just come to realize that the remarks that they were giving, it's not up to the mark, and they should stop this. So indirectly the narrator is talking about the character of Mr. Lamb and telling that Mr. Lamb was very good human being and bears very positive nature, okay, in his mind and his personality and in his traits. And from inside, he was very beautiful, वेरी नाइस, वेरी काइंड एंड वेरी अफेक्शनेट. इवन द चिल्ड्रेन, द किड्स हु कॉल्ड मिस्टर लैम्ब लैमी लैम्ब, इवन ही गिव्स देम जेली जैम एंड चॉकलेट्स दैट ही मेड. सो ही डज नॉट डिफ्रेंशिएट. सो दिस इज द हाइट ऑफ यू नो पॉजिटिविटी, हाइट ऑफ यू नो गुडनेस. डेरी, बट यू कांट पुट ऑन ट्राउजर्स, यू कैन पुट ऑन ट्राउजर्स एंड कवर इट अप एंड नो वन सी, दे डोंट हैव टू नोटिस एंड स्टेयर. नाउ द नरेटर इज टेलिंग हियर दैट द चिल्ड्रेन यूजुअली कंपेयर एंड कंट्रास्ट, दे ओनली सी द गुडनेस इन अदर्स एंड अग्लीनेस इन देमसेल्व्स. ही इज टेलिंग दैट योर कंडीशन इज डिफरेंट. Whatever conditions you are having, it is, I think, up to the mark. Now see how he contrasts. He is telling that if you are having a thin leg, you can just mask it, okay? You can just cover it and nobody can see. But my face is burnt and anyone can see and criticize it. So now you yourself see that which was the big ailment, which was the big trouble. It was for Mr. Lamb. Or it was for Derry. So Derry was having only burnt face and he can do all the activity, he can perform all kinds of work, but Mr. Lamb was not there. If someone is blind, if someone is dumb, if someone is deaf, if someone is lame, so this is the biggest, you know, elements in a human characters or human personality and his appearance, and that man, that woman will definitely not enjoy his life, okay, nicely. But if someone is having burnt face, I think, okay, and the narrator thinks that they can enjoy their life and they will not face any kind of problem, they can do anything. But still, in this case, the narrator is showing that how teenage boy, okay, teenage children, just criticize the situation. They are in it, okay. They always show their trouble. They don't want to be resourceful. They don't want to show the... So the sense of courage and confidence to just come out with the problems and find out the way to sort out the problems, they are in it. They just always criticize their condition and the problem they are, okay, or the situation they are in. So this is the case that the narrator wanted, okay, that the children should develop a sense of resourcefulness, okay. Resourcefulness means develop a sense of just finding out the solution of your problem that you are. Don't depend every time on someone else. Mr. Lamb, some do, some don't. They get tired of it. In the end, there is plenty of other things to stare at. Means he is telling that some do, but some don't. They criticize and call me Lamy Lam. And some people just hide their ailments, okay, weaknesses. But I don't do that. Derry, like my face, Mr. Lamb, like crab apples or the weeds or a spider climbing up a silken ladder or my tall sunflowers. He is just telling about the beautiful things, okay, the nice things or the optimistic nature that he looked at or looks at, okay, in the garden in a form of crab apples, weeds and the spider just climbing, okay, up a silk ladder or the sunflowers he is having, okay, in his garden. Derry, things, Mr. Lamb. Yes, it is all relative. Yes, this is very much important. Relative chapters, you are familiar with that? Relativity. Here, relative means refers to all the plants are relatives. All the animals are relatives. All things are relatives. He is telling in this way, okay? But actually, he means that everyone is having his own importance. And no one is big and no one is small. They are relatives means they are friends, they are equal. And ही इज टेलिंग दैट इफ देर इज ए ब्लैक देन देर इज ए व्हाइट इफ देर इज ए स्काई देर इज ए अर्थ एंड इफ देर इज नो अर्थ देर इज नो इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ ए स्काई इफ देर इज ए मीन्स ही इज ट्राइंग टू से दैट इफ देर इज डे देर इज नाइट सो इन एब्सेंस ऑफ एनी वन ऑफ देम इफ देर इज नो नाइट देर इज नो इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ डे एंड इफ देर इज नो डे देर इज नो इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ नाइट सो दिस इज द रिलेटिव ओके सो दिस पॉइंट इज वेरी मच इम्पोर्टेंट एंड इज टेलिंग दैट ऑल इट्स ऑल रिलेटिव ब्यूटी एंड द बेस्ट दे ऑल आर रिलेटिव ब्यूटी एंड द बेस्ट ऑल्सो डे नाइट अप डाउन गुड बैड ब्लैक व्हाइट दीज आर द क्वाइन वर्ड्स ओके इज टेलिंग दैट दे आर जस्ट द माइटी वन द ब्रेव वन द ब्रेव वन ओके द वीक वन द हैंडसम द अगली ब्यूटिफुल सो दीज आर द थिंग्स ही इज टेलिंग इन द क्वाइन वर्ड ट्राइंग टू से दैट दे आर रिलेटिव ओके एंड दे बियर्स इक्वल इम्पोर्टेंस इन इट डेरी वॉट इज दैट सपोज टू मीन मीन्स वॉट डज what you want to say you tell me Mr. Lamb is telling that you tell me what you want Dairy you need not think they have not all told me that fairy story before it is not what you look like and now he is telling one fairy story he will just narrate one fairy story that there is a fairy story and in that story there was a boy or someone okay in the story he was looking very ugly and he was not liked by anyone so he requests god or the queen or someone else okay in the story and he comes before the ugly man and just under the spell of magic wands change or convert the ugly man into very beautiful one so this happens only in myths okay just like in the story of you know in Joe and Jack that we have done memories of should wizard hit mummy so there we have fairy story same kind of a story he is going to narrate in this also so we will read okay the next part actually today I had to just explain the NCERT questions means the chapter 1 that I had explained that my mother at 66 and the board questions that have been asked till now from that chapter. So we'll do it later. Let us finish this chapter. So thank you very much. And I'm sending you the homework assignment separately.